Day one, we're on the bus. It's 3:41 a.m. We're leaving in 4 minutes, but probably not. We won't leave till these four. We got Danny and Cody behind us. And we got these guys over here.
And we're pulling like a Dominicana bound.
Yep, T-minus 20 hours.
And we got Jay Johnson.
Everybody pull out your passports and IDs. You can't make me.
All right, we are in the beautiful Panama Airport.
Oh my God, are we vlogging?
Brody and Dustin.
Dude,
and we're trying to go find something to eat.
I'm a little upset
and
no
use the bathroom.
McDonald's,
no McDonald's. That's
but there
a shame.
Is the world's
we have four food. Hours to kill before there we have to board our for our next flight.
Chocolate chip cookie. Right?
There is the world's best chocolate chip cookie here.
Thanks, dude.
Flight leaves at 6:45 p.m. Okay, we're waiting to get on the plane. It's 6:06 p.m.
Let's go.
We're playing Wavelength as we have been for the last 25 minutes. We just played 4 hours of Cthulhu, and I think we're about to start boarding. Going to the DR.
Well, we're in the DR. Just got off of the plane, and now we're on a bus. Actually, three buses.
Sitting next to
Zay.
Yes!
Chip and Jaden.
Back in the bus.
Going back to the MTC for the first time. Need to put our insect repellent on.
All right, we are here at Score International. At the, what is this called? The MTC?
NPC. Look at our beautiful hotel room. We got Nick, Drew, me, Trim.
Trimbo.
It's a bit small. It'll be fine.
It'll do, donkey.
Yeah. My soap exploded in my suitcase. But that's okay.
Do you want to try your phone?
Yeah, do you want to do me a favor?
We have filtered water. And can't flush the toilet paper down the toilet though. Got to throw it in the trash can.
It needs to be like
first. Yeah, I understand. I have a fast charge. Hopefully, charge a little bit.
And we are at the beach. Just chilling on the beach at Wandolia right now. Beautiful weather. Tanning with Dustin. It's really a beautiful day. Vendors have tried to sell us sunglasses, necklaces, pictures with a monkey and a parrot. A couple guys dug a really big hole. Nobody stepped on a sea urchin yet, so we're looking pretty good in that category. Yeah. Hopefully not getting sunburned. Today is Monday. We woke up at 7 for breakfast and then drove 20 minutes to our baseball game.
Played against a bunch of 15 and 16 year old Dominican kids who were mostly better than us. We ended up winning. We got scored a lot of runs on walks in the last inning or so. Beautiful day for baseball though. Beautiful weather. It was definitely hot. Glad I wore my sunscreen. Played second base for most of the game. Got hit by a pitch, which you saw, and then hit by a pickoff move. These kids are crazy, though. The best part about the day so far was probably getting to hang out with these little Dominican children that were running around our dugout while we were playing. There were probably 25, 30 of them just running around, playing with the pitchers who weren't playing, and a couple of them were in the dugout, too, so that was kind of cool. We're about to leave to go to a baseball clinic, and then in the evening, and we'll just have a free evening, I guess. Lunch was chicken and rice and beans. Very good. Basically a burrito bowl. Food's been amazing so far. The chef at SCORE is amazing, so we're eating pretty good. Dustin just sliced his toe on a rock near the pool. Pretty good, so he's getting doctored up by Nate. Haven't contracted any Zika or dengue fever yet, which is good. But yeah, one more little tidbit. We've been playing a unhealthy amount of Cthulhu, which is a card game, but yesterday we played it after dinner until curfew, which was about 6:30 to 10:30, so yeah, we've been playing that a lot. It's actually starting to rain now, which I'm not upset about. So maybe we'll cool us off for the clinic. So at the clinic, there were several infielders who were way better than me and most of us, which was kind of crazy. These kids are really, really good. Some of them clearly just started playing baseball this year and were super young. Other kids were like 14, 15 and threw 90 miles an hour. And will probably be drafted in 2 years. The worst part about this is that we just can't take pictures with any of the kids because of just privacy laws and stuff. But the clinic was awesome. Playing with the kids, teaching them. Although some of them could probably teach me. Also turns out I'm one of the best Spanish speakers on the team, which is kind of neat. So yeah, now we have a team meeting and another game tomorrow morning.
So much going on.
Do not be fooled.
This time, right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross.
Oh, I know.
This is electric.
It's Wednesday morning, January 8th, 9th. 10th, I don't really know. Yesterday was our busiest and most full and exhausting and rewarding day of the trip. We left for our game 8:30, played at a much nicer field, stadium kind of thing. I had a bunch of people there were watching, and there were a bunch of players who were signed with professional teams, which was really cool. I had two hits, which was also pretty neat. All dirt infield. It was also really, really hot. We're sweating a lot. Also very dehydrated. And then we got back to the compound, ate lunch, and immediately left for an all-girls home, which I didn't know how that was going to go, but turned out to be one of the best parts of the trip so far. We had probably a half-hour, 45-minute dance party with them, just on like a patio porch kind of thing.
just dancing in a dance circle, learning moves from them. And then we played all sorts of games with them, like nine square, volleyball, basketball, passing the soccer ball back and forth, tag. Three guys got their hair braided by them, which is pretty cool. And then at night, we went to a Dominican Winter League game, which was awesome. And you saw a video of that already, but just everybody screaming and yelling and bands playing all the time. Super exciting. The home team got smacked, but that's okay. We got to see Robinson Cano and Fernando Rodney, who are both retired MLB players. And a bunch more guys who are in the MLB who are playing for these teams. So that was pretty neat. Today we have another game, and then we're going to do another baseball clinic in the afternoon. So I got cupped and taped on my back from Nate. Felt pretty weird, but feels good. Yesterday my stomach did not feel good for most of the day. Today it feels fine now, so I think we're all right. No diseases yet. And yeah, gonna try and not sweat everything out of my body today. It's Wednesday night. We had another game this morning. But before that, we stopped at the Seattle Mariners Dominican Republic Baseball Academy, which was gorgeous. Beautiful fields, perfectly mowed grass, beautiful facility, workout room, chapel. In fact, the pastor slash interpreter, Roberci, that has been with us all week, works there on Tuesday nights as kind of a pastor, and he also teaches English to the guys there. So that was pretty neat. We got to take a tour of that facility. And because of that, we were an hour late to the game, which was fine. We ended up winning that one again, 5-1 or something, I don't know. But we're 3-0 in the DR. But more importantly than that, there's a lot of cool spiritual growth happening on the baseball team. We've had devos every night after dinner, a lot of guys sharing their testimonies, and it's been really neat to see the relationships that we've been able to form with each other, but also with people that we've been able to meet. We had another clinic this afternoon. A ton of kids were there. It's been awesome being able to talk to them, communicate with them. Super glad that I was able to take Spanish classes through high school, because I'm actually able to have conversations with these kids. We're able to share the gospel with them after the clinic is over as a whole group. And I was also able to talk to some of the kids individually. I'll probably be watching some of them on TV in a couple of years because they're really, really good. Some of them don't even have a glove. I gave away all the old gloves that I had, but there's still a bunch of them that come up to me and everybody else afterwards asking to have my glove or my hat or my sunglasses. Yeah, it's been really, really awesome. Tomorrow, we have our last game, and we learned that we were going back to the girls' home instead of the other thing that we were going to do, which I believe was a boys' home. So we're going back to the girls' home, which everybody's excited about because we had such a good time there on Tuesday, yesterday. So really looking forward to that. We were in the pool for a little bit tonight after our devotion. What else? Yeah, don't really want to leave, but we only got a few days left.
Swim.
We're on our way back from our last game. We won. Gilly pitched in the last inning.
My arm hurts.
His arm hurts.
It hurt before I pitched, too.
Jake Brown also pitched in the last inning.
My arm also hurts.
His arm also hurts.
Yeah, Gilly.
Stein played left field in the last inning.
He made a sweet catch.
I don't think his arm hurts quite as much.
Well.
My arm doesn't hurt, but I made a catch. But also, I listened to my head coach.
So we're 4-0 in the DR.
Don't forget about Easley.
Josh Easley played first base in the last inning. Oh, got a ground ball. He also missed one that I threw to him in the air.
That'll happen.
That'll happen. That's fine. Now we're going back to get lunch and go to the girls' home again. Well, it's Thursday night. We just had another amazing day at the girls' home, playing all sorts of games with them, dancing with them, just being goofy, laughing. They're all hilarious and awesome to be with. I gave one of the girls, her name is Brianni, a baseball. Wrote both of our names on it, and Jesus will always be with you in Spanish. So it was a cool connection that I was able to make with her. And then just now we had a team Devo, and we had Roberci, who is our translator, share with us about his life. And also Luca shared his testimony, which was super powerful. And he's actually going to be getting baptized at the beach tomorrow. So that'll be super exciting. Yeah, a lot of great things taking place. You never know when you're going to have an impact on somebody's life. So, yeah, we got one more day tomorrow, free day for the most part, and then we leave on Saturday. We're in the Santo Domingo. We were just at the first market, now we're going to a second one. I got a t-shirt and a hat so far. We're back at the beach for Friday afternoon, last day before we go home. It's another beautiful day. It's Saturday, January 13th. It's 9:45 a.m. We got less than 2 hours before we're taking off for the airport. I don't think anybody really wants to leave. We all have had such a blast here. Trav just shared his testimony. And it's been awesome to see God work on this team. And to be honest, I think our team has been most impacted by what God has done this week. And I know we've impacted a lot of people this week, whether it's the girls at the girls home, kids at the clinic, or the teams that we've played against in our games. God was very present this week. And definitely will be sad to go back, but I'm also ready to go back and spend a whole semester with these guys again. So it's been a fantastic week. Beautiful weather. Not ready to go back to 30s and rain, but it is what it is. Yeah, back to PA.